something. You have a criminal mind. I'm damn sure.
Criminal mind.
I like things. I want to fly on your 787.
No need, brother. You no need like Biman. You no need. I don't need. No need.
Hello and welcome to Dubai. It's going to be a very different flight review because I didn't even get on the plane. It's 2 a.m. here in Dubai. Why am I up so early? Well, I'm not even supposed to be in this country right now because I was supposed to fly with Biman Bangladesh Airlines 2 hours ago at 5 minutes past midnight. But I got denied boarding and was treated very badly. Here's what happened. So I made a review about Biman Bangladesh Airlines Boeing 737 back in 2020. I had quite a good experience and the video got pretty popular. So this time I decided to review the airline's business class product on its Boeing 787 widebody aircraft. Now, Biman does fly its 787 from Dubai to Dhaka. However, it's a midnight flight. I would like to do a daytime flight. So I have several options. From Dhaka, I can do Dhaka to Daman, and then Dhaka to London or Dhaka to Toronto. Now, from Dhaka to Daman was the cheapest option, and from Dubai to Dhaka to Daman only cost me $80 more than flying from Dhaka straight to Daman. So I thought, I'm already in Dubai, why don't I just book a flight like that? And 24 hours before the flight, I was able to check in online. So I did check in online on my phone and was emailed a boarding pass. So I used the boarding pass to enter Dubai Airport's customs area. There was no problem with that. And then at the boarding gate, that's where I got stopped.
Our airline concern,
yeah.
Where are you going? You're going to Bangladesh,
yeah,
for what reason?
If the airline sold me the ticket and I have all the documents required.
You bought it online. No one will stop you online. You can buy any ticket.
Yeah, but it's from the official Biman Bangladesh Airlines website. It's from the official website.
You choose to buy the ticket. No one sells it for you. You choose it.
No one told me I can't fly.
It's not illegal.
Look, I have the documents required. I have the documents required.
Why are you not choosing from here to
Because
Saudi Arabia? Why?
I am a YouTuber. I like planes. I travel. I want to fly on Biman Bangladesh, and this is the only way I can do it. Because you fly to Bangkok on a 737. You don't fly to Bangkok on a 787. You don't fly to Singapore on a 787. I want to fly on a 787. Flights to Toronto, too expensive.
I don't know this visa is okay or not. Saudi Arabia, they will find 5,000.
I can't get visa on arrival.
Who will take this risk? $5,000? Who will take this responsibility? Look, I can't get visa on arrival.
It's not my problem. You can't verify my e-visa. You can't verify my e-visa. That's not my problem. I have return ticket as you required. Why can't I travel now? I have return ticket.
You talk to him.
I talked to him. He said talk to you.
No.
Why?
Illegal traffic.
Which law says I can't travel?
Lots of people are traveling
illegally. Which law? Tell me the law. Then.
Yeah. This is illegal.
Wait, which law? Bangladesh law? Dubai law? Saudi Arabia law?
From here to Saudi Arabia. Why are you going Bangladesh back?
Let's just lower the voice down. Let's be
no.
calm.
You're doing something. You have a criminal mind. I'm damn sure.
Criminal mind. I just want to fly Biman Bangladesh to Saudi Arabia. They think I have a criminal mind. I paid $1,300 to fly on this airline, and you don't let me fly.
He wants to travel Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia here to 1 hour travel. 1 hour from Dubai to Saudi Arabia. He wants to go Bangladesh, 6 hours, then 8 hours is transit. Then he will go come back here, back in Middle East.
I also have an e-visa, which they think it's fake, so they don't let me fly. Already paid $1,300 for the flight. They don't let me fly. Doesn't make sense, does it?
Where are you from?
I'm from Australia.
Australia?
Yeah. Well,
so you paid already? So
I paid already. I have all the documents required. They don't let me fly because they think it's suspicious. I'm a travel vlogger. I want to fly on a specific aircraft. So I don't see the problem with that. I can fly with Air France, with Lufthansa. Never had a problem with it.
It's so weird.
Their main problem is, why am I flying from Dubai to Dhaka to Dammam instead of flying direct Dubai to Dammam? They do have a point, because the flight time from Dubai to Dhaka is 6 hours, then Dhaka to Dammam is 6 hours, total flight time is 12 hours, and the transit time in Bangladesh is 6 hours, and the direct flight from Dubai to Dammam is just 1 hour. But what they don't understand is, I'm a YouTuber, I review airlines. I want to fly with Biman Bangladesh Airlines. My point is not to fly to Saudi Arabia. I'm happy to fly anywhere. I'm happy to fly to Bangkok if they offer the Boeing 787 service to Bangkok, but they don't. So then they asked for my visa. So I said, yeah, I have e-visa for Saudi Arabia. They looked at my e-visa and I think it's fake. They said, it's fake. Then I said, you can check. They said they don't have the facility to check if the visa is real. They suspect it's fake. I said, how about we go to Saudia, the flag carrier of Saudi Arabia. We go to Saudia's counter. I can show the staff my e-visa, and if they think it's real, then just let me board.
You have an ill motive.
Ill motive because I'm not flying a normal route. But I told you already. I like planes. I want to fly on your 787.
No need, brother. You no need like Biman. You no need.
I don't
need. No need.
That's very rude no of need. You. I no. didn't say I like Biman or not.
Sir,
I like
$5,000 fine. $5,000 fine.
I have the document. You can't check. It's not my problem. I have EVs. I've been to Saudi Arabia just in March.
Brother.
787.
Hello.
Good seat.
If you're not going to Saudi Arabia.
I'm going to Saudi Arabia.
Yeah, here is Saudi Arabia.
Yeah, but I want to fly with Biman. What's wrong with that?
This is suspicious troubling. Suspicious troubling.
Are you a
suspicious
police?
Troubling.
You are not a police.
That's why, yeah.
You are not the immigration
yes,
officer.
Not, yeah.
What law are you
airlines.
Talking
I'm
about?
I'm the airlines. They will fine to the airlines. I am
what?
Not happy with you.
I'm not happy with you.
No.
I just want to fly.
No.
I just
no.
want to fly.
You
Look.
Cannot fly. You cannot fly by Biman. We are not taking you. Because it's illegal.
Tell suspicious me your name traffic. Then so I can complain to your airline. What's your name? Can I know your name?
No need to name. No need.
Why no need?
So this is the end of my footage. I filmed all these just to gather information so I can complain to the airline later on. Then one of the staff saw that I was filming, he told that manager, and the manager suddenly came over, threatened to ask me to delete all the footages. I said, I only filmed myself, I didn't film any of you. And then he threatened to call the police. He said, you will be in deep shit. You will have to explain very well to the man. You will be in very big trouble. And so I was like, okay, I'll just leave then. I'll just leave. And now I will tell my experience to you guys, and hopefully Biman Bangladesh Airlines will see this video as well. So what happened after was I was asked by the Dubai customs to get a offload paper or something like that, and then I was able to get back to UAE without any questions asked. Biman Bangladesh Airlines, if you're watching this, I really hope I could get an apology from you guys. A proper apology. I don't think I was treated very nicely, and I was flying business class. I was supporting your business class. Your business class from Dhaka to Saudi Arabia was empty. I was like the third passenger out of how many seats you get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 24 seats. There was only 3 passengers in business class. I was supporting you, and I didn't even get to be on the plane. I think a proper visa check from other airlines is they check on the IATA website, check my nationality, and check the visa requirement. They didn't even do that. If they checked it, they would see that I can get an e-visa and I can get a visa on arrival. They didn't even check it, so they wouldn't know, and they just assumed that I'm doing illegal activity because I'm flying the long way. They probably don't understand what YouTube is. It's just very disappointing. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you're planning to fly with Biman Bangladesh Airlines, make sure you don't make the same mistake as I did. Their business class is really expensive. The price isn't really that competitive. I just want to try them out. That's why I flew with them. So clearly, this didn't end up very well. I don't think I'll fly with them again. Thank you again for watching, and I'll see you all in my next video.